going on, guys? Welcome back and thanks for tuning in at JWTV yet again. Now, before I start this video, I'm sure you've all guessed what it is by the title. But before I start, can I just say a big thank you? And I know everyone's tired of hearing all this soppy bollocks business and all this soppy shit, and I don't like it either. But YouTube's a thing. I mean, you get a lot of viewers and you gotta pay your respect back to them viewers. It's not just a case of you making them videos. You have to pay your respect back to them viewers. Yes, you may do your weekly giveaways now and then. You may interact with them, but you have to give back. They take the time to subscribe to you, they watch to you, they like your videos, and that's what I'm doing now. So can I just say a thank you for the support my last video got? If you didn't know, go and check it out. It's to do with the Lord Bentner one. It actually got a lot more views than I expected, and that is the reason why I'm thanking you. I didn't think it'll get over 200. I didn't expect that. It's probably like me third highest viewed video or something along the lines. So, but it's the like targets. If you read the descriptions of my video, I said get this video to 3 likes, or I recorded, because I was going to do a FIFA 17 pack opening anyway, but I said 3 likes for a recorded FIFA 17 pack opening. And you guys smashed it. You guys hit 8 likes. I'm sorry I can't put it all on the screen. If I could, I would. I'm not that great at the editing. But thanks, guys, for those who watch me, those who subscribe, those who like my videos and content. Thanks for staying there. And I hope within time I will get better at editing. I will get better at gaming and bringing out better video ideas. But thank you for that support. So you guys, one more like and we've tripled that like target. So as promised, once FIFA 17 comes out, or a couple of days after, once I can get me on something, because it's going to be, I mean, there's going to be shops, there's going to be 50 people in a queue lined up outside game on midnight to get it. So wait till it's died down. The minute I get that game, the minute I get that set up, because I'm going to need a lot of time, so I will get that recorded pack up in for you. And that is another big issue that I'm going to say. If those of you who have watched my public career modes and other FIFA episodes, gaming episodes, my Fable episodes, you would see that the layout, the camera, the setup isn't entirely great there. I haven't got an Elgato, I'm struggling with a bit of money at the minute, I can't find it. And the purpose of YouTube wasn't a job, it wasn't going to what these done. But I done this when I'd finished college. I finished my first year, I'm still at college, but when I finished my first year. So I obviously finished my first year, I had about 4 months off, and I just thought, you know, these four months have been really crap, they've been really boring, I just want something to do. So I was watching a few YouTube videos and they inspired me, you know, likes of KSI, Miniminta. Whether I get to the likes of them is an entirely different concept, but they inspired me, and I purely done it as probably a little bit of money on the side, because I know you can get paid for that kind of stuff, bit of money on the side, and just as a hobby. I mean, it's somewhat just playing FIFA on your own or something, but then interacting with your viewers, maybe interacting over Twitter, getting a bit more sociable, it's a bit different. So I've just done that as a bit of a hobby. So for those of you who still enjoy me public career modes, me FIFA episodes, without the use of an Elgato and very good editing software, face cams, etc., thanks, guys. And until I get an Elgato, there's not much I can do. I will try and sort something out, whether I get a stand or a shelf or something, and stick my camera on there. But at the minute, it's looking a bit down in the dumps. But I will bring it out, so you will be expecting that. Don't worry, you can stay this channel for that. When FIFA's out, I'll be doing a lot more of that. But as I said, it's just the camera setup is a bit unfortunate at the minute. So just wait till I get that out. But as I said, I'm sorting something out. I could try and move things around, try and install a shelf or get a couple of pillows and do something. But I'll sort it out. But anyway, back onto the video. You guys smash that like target. We've hit 8 likes. You've smashed that target. Thanks for the support. Thanks to the subscribers. I gained a couple of subscribers in the past couple of days as well, so thanks for that. I hope I'm not discouraging you too much from this channel, due to we used to upload 10 videos a week, and now I'm sort of skipping days out. But as I said in the other videos, that is because of the transfer window's over, so I can't do many videos out, and that's what my videos consisted of. And obviously FIFA 16 has just collapsed, it's died, it's ended. So until FIFA 17 is out, I can't do much. And the only reason I'm doing this today is to thank you guys for the support I've been getting. And the main one is the title of this video. And I know you've heard me rant on for minutes about thanking you, but and it's soppy. I'm fucking boring myself, but it's a pretty soppy. But and I'm sure you guys hate all this soppy nonsense. But on with the video. Thank you for the support. Last thing I'm gonna say. First, get this video to 3 likes and get this video to 3 likes and in the comments put what you want to see on FIFA 17. So 3 likes, put a FIFA 17 feature slash series you want to see, and the one that gets the most likes on that comment I shall also do. If that doesn't make sense, I'll explain it to the end. But on with the main topic of the video. If you haven't already guessed by the title, and it is that it came shocking to me, that's what I'm making it. That PSG in that transfer window, so ready, it's off BBC Sports, off Sky Sports. PSG offered £160 million for Neymar with a £650,000 a week wage. Now, in the comments, guys, I'm going to get this over and done without. In the comments, has money in football become absolutely stupid? I mean, what? Four weeks in a month, he earns £650,000 a week. 600 times 4, 6, 5, 8, 20, 2.4 million. Neymar's averaging, if he had took that deal, he would have been averaging £2.7 million a month. He can get two Bugattis in a month. He can get a frigging house in a month. He can get a boat in a month. But that is what I want to know in the comments. Has football and money finally, well, it's been going crackers for ages. But as it finally comes to its bitter end money, it's just stupid. I mean, £650,000 a week, that's like, wow. I mean, freaking hell, that's wow. But now, we're not going to discuss the topics we discussed in the transfer. If this was a transfer, we'd have discussed the topics, what can he bring, etc. But we're going to talk about the money side. I mean, wow, look at me. Different coloured hands, the sun's coming out. But anyway, we've got to be talking about the money side. So, we've covered that money's ridiculous. I mean, £160 million. Neymar's what, 23, 24? He's 6, 7 years older than me. And he would have been on that money. He could have been driving a Bugatti or two in a month. He could have been having a house in a month, a high-end house. Money's stupid. So, that is the first topic we will discuss. That money has finally come to its bitter end, and if Neymar is worth £160 million, it just makes you think what Messi and Ronaldo are worth. Yeah, Neymar's a lot younger, and Neymar still have his yet prime to come. I think he's only 23. Prime time for me, I think he's about 26, 27, that's what I think. And by the time he's there, I think he will be the best player in the world. Because Ronaldo and Messi in the World Cup, Messi's going to be 31, Ronaldo's going to be 33. And in the World Cup, Neymar's going to be about 27 in prime time. So I think, along with Pogba, that they will be some of the best midfielders in some of the best players in the world, if not the best, especially Neymar. So, next point, which that kind of relates to our next point. What does this £160 million prove? Does it prove that he could be one of the best players in the world? That he is, that his appetite for the game, or just his pure quality? Let me know in the comments, guys, why you think Neymar has such a price tag and such a wage target, and why does he have that? So, let's talk about the next part. What can he bring to football in the next season, prime time? I think he can be the best in the world. FIFA, for example, FIFA try and relate everything realistically. He's got many team scene cards, many inform cards, 5-star weak foot, 5-star skill moves. I know we can't relate FIFA to this, but they're trying to get it as realistic as they can, and it shows he can use both feet. He's got great footwork. His ability to use both feet is fantastic. He can finish, he can dribble, he's pacey, he's a decent passer of the ball. The only thing he can't do is defend, and he's very weak, which sometimes can affect his speed and balance. If you have Mertesacker, don't matter how slow Mertesacker is, if you have Mertesacker who's got a couple of yards on Neymar, he's just going to show how to barge him off the ball. It's simple as so. Neymar's strength lets him down. Whereas if you like Ronaldo, Ronaldo's got crap balance, but his strength's good. So despite him having good strength, he could still be nudged off that ball due to that balance. So let me know in the comments your guys' strengths in football. Are you quick? Are you good finishers of the ball? Can you head a ball? Can you jump? Me, I would just say I'm quick. I won't go into too much. If you've seen the 3 football videos on this channel, Pin the Ball on the Brother, call-out penalties and football challenges, you will know all I could probably do is run, and you haven't even seen me running that, but I can run, guys. Trust me, I can run. But, no, if you've seen the football, I know we're kind of drifting off lately, so instead of naming it PSG offered $160 million for Neymar, let's call this a thank you and what can I do video. But anyway, but it kind of relates, you see where I'm coming from, it kind of relates that this $160 million price tag can prove that Neymar is a big player, and in years to come he will be the best player in the world. So sorry we haven't discussed too much, I've spent more time thanking you guys in this video than I have speaking about that, this situation, so I'm going to have to think about rewording the title now, but that's all we could discuss, really. The money that Neymar would have been on, and what does that money prove? Does it prove he's one of the best in the world? Does it prove he's great at one specific trait, his appetite for the game, or just pure quality like Ibrahimovic, Pogba, Ronaldo, etc.? And that would have been a world record fee, $160 million. That's ridiculous. Pogba's cost 80, not 90, 89. He's doubled it. Neymar would have doubled it, so. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching this video. Sorry I spent more time thanking you. I know you guys are thinking, shut the fuck up right now. But I'm sorry for that, guys. But I am grateful for everything, every subscriber I get, every like I get, every comment I get. And if it means to in a year or two that I could become a big-time YouTuber maybe and see where it takes me, so be it. But I need you guys to do your part as well, as you've been doing. 14 more subscribers to go. Let's hit that road to 50. Once we hit that road to 50, it will be another footballing video, and this time you guys will get to decide what football we do. Whether it be a match, more challenges, skill moves, a Panners game between me and my brother, who you have seen on this channel before in the football games. But you guys decide it. Let's just hit 14 more subscribers. Let's get this video to 3 likes. And let's do it. I'm so glad to say, but thanks for watching this video, guys. This video has ran for about 14 minutes now, so again, thank you. Thank you for the support. Remember to subscribe, like, you know, all that load of rubbish. Not rubbish, but you go do it. You go do it. You go leave some comments. You go follow me on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, etc. You go and do it. You go smash the hell out of it. And I will see you guys in a bit.